Alright guys, in this video we'll be doing the inclusion room from TryHackMe, and the name says it's a local file inclusion. So and the IP address is 10.10.114.166. Let's do the nmap scan, and I have already done the nmap scan to save some time, and only two ports are open. SSH port is open and web server port is open. Let's go and visit the web server. And hello world, welcome to my blog Hacking This World, and LFI attack and RFI attack. So let's click on this view details. So this is the description of LFI, how to perform. So here the LFI attack is the file name, and it is being the contents of the LFI attack is being included in this article page. So this article page consists of some articles. So if you want to include the code from LFI attack, so you don't need to copy paste into this article file. So what you can do is you can say name is equals to LFI attack. So the contents of this file will be automatically included in this article page. Now what you can do is instead of LFI attack, you can say hc passwd. Now it says internal server error. Okay, now what you can do is we can go further up towards root directory, and then you can try to read the contents, and you can see these are the contents of the passwd file. Now you can search for users, and there is one user falconfished, and you can see there is a comment falconfished root password. So these are the credentials for the SSH login. So now what we are going to do is we can directly go on and login with this falconfished and root password. So but now in normal case scenarios, what you can do, what you have is you will not have the credentials in this. Then what you can do is you can poison the logs, and you can execute the get a remote code execution. So first let's search for proc self environ. So this contains the our request parameters headers. So those will be stored as an environment variable. So these are the environment variables, root pwd. Okay, so that means our request headers are not being included in the environment variables. So if in normal case scenarios, if they are using like CGI technologies, then what the request headers that you are sent by the this request will be included as a environment variables. Now you can send the PHP reversal in that, and whenever you open this file again, you will get the reversal. You can see what ports are open. SSH port is open and web server port is open. So you can go for var log authentication.log. So this is the log file for SSH. So if you go back, and you can see it is using some Flask based web application. So Flask is a framework written in Python, just like Django. So that means this is just a static page, not a PHP render. So if you poison this with PHP, you will not get any reversal. Okay, let's go ahead and do that. So SSH, what you are going to do is you can say text69 @ the IP address of the machine. And paste here and type yes. Now type in the password, some blah blah blah, wrong password. Again type in the wrong password. Again type the wrong password. Now this attempt of this attempt will be logged in this var log author.log. Now refresh this. Now search for text69. So now you can see invalid user text69. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to include this PHP code. PHP system of $_get_of_c. @this IP address. So you need to do some modifications. So what I am doing is, instead of this text name, I am sending this one, just a PHP code. Put the quotation and hit enter. Okay, cancel this. So you can see here these single quotes are getting missed. Put the double quotes here, and you want to escape this dollar. Put the backward slash here. Okay, now you can see we are logging in as this user. Now type the password, etc. Okay, now let's refresh this again. Now search for PHP. So now we can see the code is being so now you can see this one is the actual PHP code. So this one is being rendered as a plain text. If the backend is PHP, then this what you need to do is, you can say end CA is equals to who am I. So of course you will not get any, because this is not this is just a static site. It does not contain the backend. So in case if you have the PHP as a backend, you can try like this. So one way you can try is you can ping like 5 packets to our IP address. So this will make sure that we are getting actually code execution. 10.114.166, and type of the packet is ICMP. Now hit enter. You will not get any ICMP packets because the PHP code we have injected, it's not being rendered because that is not PHP backend. So what port is open? What else port is open? Port 80 is open. So you can go to, if the web server is Apache, you can go to http://access.log, or you can also search for access.log. So this is not HTTP, sorry, Apache. Now you can copy this workjug HTTP log location. Okay, I think there are no logs for this. Flask logs stored. So I don't know about this Python Flask framework. So I'm not going to go further because I don't know where the Flask locations. So if you have the Apache server, then you can try for https://log. Then you can poison by capturing the request in the burp suite and changing the user agent to this PHP code. So you will get the remote code execution. So okay, that's all for this LFI. Now let's see RFI. So meanwhile, let's go and view the contents of hcpasswd. So this is the username and the password we need to log in. So this is the RFI attack. So this instead of the local file, you can press the remote file. So instead of remote file, you need to host the remote file. So nano . So let me create this. So now let's host this. Okay, we are hosting this file. Okay, let's copy this IP address. And now what we are going to do is HTTP. /phprce.php and c is equals to who am I. Okay, there it's php. Now you should see some get requests. So we should see at least a get request, right? I don't know why it's 8000 php rc.php. Okay, let's leave that one. I don't know what the error is. At least we should, that box should try to get the file from this one. So SSH falconfished and the password is root password. So we have the password. Let's go and search for our privileges, and you can see you can execute the socket as a root user. While executing, you will get no password prompt. So let's go to GTFO bins. You can also generate the reverse shell socket. So this one should give us sudo usr bin slash the shell. So now hit enter. Now type who am I root, cd root ls root.txt. So you can grab the root.txt. So this is a normal box, a simple one, but you need to learn different types of the log poisoning when you have the LFI vulnerability.